so chapter 3, section 4. Section 4 is all about parallel and perpendicular lines and how they're related to each other. This is important. I want you guys writing down the theorems, okay? I want you to write down the words and draw a picture. I want you to know what the theorems say. The reason this is extra important is because a few of these theorems don't have names. If a theorem doesn't have a name, you can't refer to it by its name. You have to say the words of the theorem. Okay, so if you don't know what the words of the theorem are, then you can't refer to it. So here's what the first theorem says. If two lines are parallel to the same line, then they are parallel to each other. It's not that many words. Okay, so if A and B are both parallel to the same line, C, then that means A and B are parallel to each other. Yeah. It makes sense, right? All those lines are parallel.
It's basically the transitive property of parallel lines.
Now with symbols, okay, it says if A is parallel to B, and B is parallel to C, then A is parallel to C. It's sort of like a transitive property of parallel lines.
Oh my gosh, Chan.
It's transitive.
In your notes, if you want to abbreviate, that's great.
Oh, well, you can.
Now, on the test, if you abbreviate something and it doesn't make sense to me, that's not great.
That's when is our next toaster push?
I don't know.
Tomorrow.
No.
Tomorrow.
It is tomorrow.
Quiz or test?
It's a test.
It's a test.
No.
Quiz. Look at PowerSchool. Every week you guys should be looking at PowerSchool.
I did kind of sort of. I just didn't really look hard.
Highlighted in bold. All
right, I got
Tuesday,
it. Tuesday.
Classwork.
Right,
3 points.
Right,
clearly
yellow.
You didn't get it, so he's helping you out.
No, I got it the first time I said it.
All
right, let's look at the next theorem. That doesn't have a name.
Oh, okay.
Now, you don't really have to worry about, like, in a plane. Okay, if you leave that part out, I'm not going to kill you for it. Technically, all of these are in a plane, so don't worry about that part. But it says, if two lines are perpendicular to the same line, okay, so if N is perpendicular to T and N is perpendicular to T, then they are parallel to each other. So if they're perpendicular to the same line, they are perpendicular to each other. If two lines are perpendicular to the same line, they are parallel to each other.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So, like the one before it was like 3/8, and then this one's like 3/9. Are they like the same? Can you like...
No. Bless you. They're different, and the only reason I say 3/8 and 3/9 is because we're in chapter 3, and that was the 8th theorem that the book talks about. If I go into a different geometry book, it's going to be called something else. So that's why I'm telling you it's important to know the words. So that on a test, I might give you something like this.
Perpendicular.
No, something.
Oh my. Don't.
And you have to fill in the blanks.
Our parallel lines. Oh.
Okay.
Well, it depends. It could
two.
Be either
is
of those.
Good or bad?
Really? Either of the two, we just
want
to run. You can
yeah.
tell
yeah.
either one.
Both.
So this
really?
One's transitive property with perpendicular.
Kind of, but it doesn't say that they're perpendicular to each other. It's parallel.
I was
All right, let's look at the last one that does have a name. Now, it does have a name, but I still want you to know what it says. It's called the Perpendicular Transversal Theorem. We abbreviate it PTT. It's called the Perpendicular Transversal Theorem because the transversal is the perpendicular one. So what it says is, if a line is perpendicular to one of two parallel lines, then it's also perpendicular to the other one. So, if you have two parallel lines and one and the transversal is perpendicular to one of them, then that transversal will also be perpendicular to the other one.
Makes sense.
Oh, I'm going to go.
The first case is weird, but that's that.
Now, you can phrase this a different way. but
It just has to make sense.
I don't really trust you to do that.
But I'm not
No, it would have to mean the same thing.
It would have to mean the exact same thing. So maybe you could say no.
I got you.
Like, well, I rephrased it actually. So this says if a line is perpendicular to one of two parallel lines, then it is also perpendicular to the other. So you could say if a line is perpendicular to one line and that line is perpendicular to another line, then the transversal is also perpendicular to the other.
But this one makes more. This one makes easier sense.
It's they're always going to give you like the most concise way to say it.
I'm not done yet.
Now again, on a quiz or test, I'm going to leave you some blanks. You're mostly just going to be filling in the blanks.
Would there like a white box?
Hmm?
Would there be like a white box?
Probably just like an underline.
Roll my head.
Because boxes are harder to make than me underlining.
Are you something drink?
No.
Hurry up.
You're gonna give us a question just like you do. So apples. Two and one of them is perpendicular.
So if a transversal is perpendicular to one line, it's also perpendicular to a line that's parallel to that one. Alright, any questions? These are kind of like common sense, right? Yeah, they make sense when you think about them. They'll make sense if you're drawing pictures of them too. But it's important to know that someone did prove them. They didn't just come out of nowhere.
It depends.
So for example, let's look at theorem 3.9. If T, the transversal, is perpendicular to M and N, then that means that these two angles are what?
90 degrees.
What kind of angles are these angles right here?
Right angles.
Okay, but in relation, no, that's not wrong, that's correct. In relation to the parallel lines.
They're
corresponding. No, they're
corresponding.
They're corresponding angles. So one way to quickly prove this is, okay, so it's perpendicular to both of these. By definition of perpendicular, these two are both 90. And then by the converse, the corresponding angle theorem, we've now created two parallel lines. So it's provable. Like I just proved it with words in a in a couple sentences, right? And so they all can be proved pretty quickly like that.
So would you want us to prove it like that on the test?
I don't know. I don't think we'll probably won't prove these. These are kind of challenging.
Yeah,
that's a lot of work. Yeah. But we will look at some paragraph proofs.
That's fun.
Alright, so I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can, because I know these words are kind of small. This is an example of a paragraph proof. So we've done two column proofs, so let's just review. So two column proof has statements and reasons. Every statement has a reason. Okay? They should all be paired up and lined up. Okay, every statement has a reason. You don't say stuff unless you can say a reason for it. You also don't give reasons that don't have statements that go with. Your first statement is always the
given.
Last statement is always the
answer.
Yeah, like the proof, like the answer, what you're trying to get to. And then stuff in between is more, they're just like little bridges to get there. Yeah?
What's like the shortest proof that
could be? Oh, I don't know.
You could probably do a
right angles
line.
Are congruent.
Okay.
Now, then we did flow proofs. So remember, flow proofs are really just like filling in the blanks. So those will continue to be more like fill in the blank type proofs, and they kind of flow. So it's still first thing is the given, and then there's some stuff in between, and then they flow to the proof. So let's look at this paragraph proof. So here's the given. It's in the picture. It says that C is perpendicular to B. So C and B are perpendicular. B is perpendicular to D, so again, you see the perpendicular. And then D is perpendicular to A, so D is perpendicular to A. They want you to prove that C is perpendicular to A. So they're trying to make you prove that, basically. That if I extend C, it will be perpendicular. Now, it looks perpendicular, right? That seems like it will be. But we can't just be like, yeah, because it looks like it in the picture. Never write that.
Oh, no.
Never write that. Never assume. All right, so let's read the proof. It says, Logan, can you read the first sentence? It's kind of long.
Okay, line C and D are both perpendicular to line B. So C and,
C parallel to D because two lines perpendicular to the same line are parallel.
Alright, so this part right here, it says lines C and D are both perpendicular to line B. How do we know that?
It was given.
It's right. So C is perpendicular, and then so it's part of the given. It doesn't say it is given that, but you could do that if you want to say it is given that line C and D are both perpendicular to line B. So then you say like something else. So
like
C and D.
C,
but you see how it says a because.
Yeah.
So the difference here, instead of like lining it up, statement reason, is you're just going to have a blah 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 and then because. Okay. So in a two-column proof, it would have been like statements and then reasons. Two lines, perpendicular, same line, parallel, each other. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. Aubrey, read this second sentence.
It is given that D, I don't know what that is.
D is perpendicular,
perpendicular to A, therefore C is perpendicular to A because a line that is perpendicular to one of those two parallel lines is also perpendicular to the other.
And then they wrote in parentheses, perpendicular transversal theorem. So if you wanted, you probably could have said, so notice also they split this up into two sentences because it kind of needed to be that way. You don't want to create a big run-on sentence, so they split it up to two. So it is given that D is perpendicular to A, you could have said, therefore C is perpendicular to A by the perpendicular transversal theorem, if you wanted to make that shorter.
So PTT.
So by PTT. All right, so what I want you guys to do, what we're going to do together.
Practice quiz?
No. We're going to look at this.
Is there a practice quiz on high school?
Yes, there is.
Yes. We're going to look at this one, and we're going to create a plan, and then turn it into a paragraph.
Oh, man. All right.
All right, so let's just like look at what we have. It says in a plane, A is perpendicular to B, so A is perpendicular to B. B, so B perpendicular to C. Yeah, B perpendicular to C, and then C is parallel to D. So that's the see the two little arrows.
Yeah.
Okay, so what we want to prove is that A is parallel to D. So this is A.
Oh, it's easy.
And this is D. We're trying to prove these are parallel. Now, let's look at our other theorems. So our other theorem said, what did the first one say?
If two lines are parallel to the same line, then they're parallel to each other.
So if they're parallel to the same line.
So that would equal AC, right? Or no, BC. No.
AC.
No, because it doesn't say AC is parallel.
How do I draw this? Alright, so if this is perpendicular parallel to this, and this is parallel to this, and they're parallel to each other. Alright, what did the second one say?
In a plane, if two lines are perpendicular to the same line, then they are parallel to each other.
Okay. And then the last one says,
if a line is perpendicular to one of two parallel lines, then it's also perpendicular to the other.
All right, so. The orange stuff is what comes after the then. Just to remember what they are. Now we're trying to prove that A is parallel to D. So which of these says that lines are going to be parallel to each other?
The first one,
but so does this one too, right?
Yeah.
If they're perpendicular to the same line, then they're going to be parallel to each other. So let's look. Are A and D perpendicular to the same line?
Yes.
Yes.
What line?
C.
D.
C is over here.
Yeah. Wait.
C
so they're not perpendicular to that.
It's a good B.
They could be parallel.
That's why.
B.
Yeah.
So someone said B.
Yeah.
So you're saying they're both perpendicular to B? Well, A is perpendicular to B, but we technically don't know that D is perpendicular to B. So we'd have to show that first. So we either need to show that first D and B are perpendicular, or what Logan was saying was if we can show, so let me just erase this so you guys can see. If we can show that A is somehow parallel to C, then these two will both be parallel because they'll be parallel to the same line. Now, I think you could probably go both ways with this, but I'm thinking Logan's line might be. don't know, let's just roll with it. How can we show that... How can we show maybe that A and C are parallel to each other?
Because they're...
Oh, they have the...
They have the...
The train with equal 180.
Tanner?
It's, well, if A is parallel to B and B is parallel to C...
You mean perpendicular?
I mean, oh, perpendicular to C, then
uh-huh.
A is perpendicular to C.
I know where you're going with that, but you said it a little backwards. So if A is perpendicular to B, right, and C is perpendicular to B, then A and C are parallel. All right, so which one says that? If they're perpendicular to the same line, they're parallel to each other.
It's just
second.
So because A and C are both perpendicular to B, we're now going to say that they're parallel to each other. All right, so we're saying it is given.
And then you just use the first.
That A and C are both perpendicular to B. Therefore, A is parallel to C, but I have to say because. So because, I have to say this theorem. So who wrote it down nicely?
Oh,
that's the second one.
Oh, I got you.
All right, so what do I say? Because.
If two lines are perpendicular to the same line, then they're parallel to each other.
Perpendicular to
one,
same
two
line.
Parallel
you
lines.
Bro?
Is also perpendicular to each
yes.
Yes.
Just look at those letters.
Mm-hmm.
Handwritten letters right there.
Handwritten letters.
Look how many
to see. Okay, I abbreviated the words perpendicular and parallel.
Oh.
Yeah.
So okay, so now I know that A and C are definitely parallel.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I can say what about A and D?
That
oh,
they are parallel because...
Yeah, they're also parallel because if two lines are parallel to the same line, then they're parallel to each other.
Right, so we can say A is parallel...